Well, hi there, I'm Thom Malone. I'm very much looking forward to the return of National Hunt Racing at Navan on Saturday. Hopefully we get one or two winners. We start off with a 2 mile maiden hurdle, and a couple of these have really decent bumper form. The likes of Risk Factor, obviously. Giraldo as well won a bumper and a point to point, and Liguan as well. He's quite highly rated for a maiden hurdle. He would be off a mark of 116 with this, a handicap, but that's a good Risk Factor. It was a bit of a tired stumble when he came down last time out, and he definitely has the best bumper form in offer, so hopefully if he can put it all together, he can hopefully take our opening race of the afternoon, that maiden hurdle at 12:40. At 10 past one, it's a handicap hurdle for lady riders, and the Mouse Doctor's won in pretty decent form, as is Mandarin Monarch, but can't really look past Arthur Fonzarelli. Really nice winner at Killarney last time out when jumping out and making all. You got Rachel Blackmore in the saddle. That's an obvious advantage from the Henry de Bromhead yard. Really nicely bred sword as well. So I'll stick with Arthur Fonzarelli to make it two wins on the spin at 10 past one. At a quarter past two, well, this is the first of two divisions of this 2 mile six handicap hurdle. I think they had 52 entries in all. So unsurprisingly, that's been divided. Last chance for Ricky Doyle to ride a winner with his claim. He's already shed it after a winner at Tremor today. So perhaps Don't Let It Go has a chance here. Off a hurdles mark of 91, were this a chase, he'd be off a mark of 102. Didn't run without promise when third when last seen at Tipperary. And like I say, Ricky Doyle's last hours of his claim on board this one. So maybe he can finish out with a winner there. In the second division of that one at 20 past two. Look, there's plenty of these with decent form. Obviously, the likes of Hewick and Trouble in Stride for first and second when last seen. That was at Kilbeggan. A little bit further down, though, just a 4-year-old Grey Girly in the Maneer and Suede colours. Give that one a bit of a chance off a mark of 82. Obviously, the top two have an unsurprising chance in this one, but perhaps a little each way bet for Grey Girly. Stepped up in trip, maybe that'll help her settle the stiff track as well. Like I say, decent third last time out when staying on, so like I say, stepping up in trip, that could help her off a very, very low mark there in the 20 past two. At 5 to 3, it's a hurdle here, and this looks an absolute bang match between Road to Dubai and also a Premium Package. Perhaps just side with Road to Dubai. On UK ratings, he'd be off a mark of 136. That'd generally be enough to win a race like this. And had a pipe opener on the flat as well. His quality on the flat too was off a mark of 82. So I think the Gordon Elliott trained Road to Dubai can take that 255 under Jack Kennedy. And of course, Gordon Elliott loves having winners at Navan. At 3:30, we've got a 2.5 mile chase there. A lot of these of us were relatively similar mark over hurdles, but I like the chance of Lever de Soleil, one of a couple of Gavin Cromwell's runners in the race. Ran into a decent horse last time out at Kilbeggan in that the point to see one from the Joseph O'Brien yard. Will be 127 over hurdles. That's well enough to be competitive against the kind of rest of these here over fences this afternoon. But Lever de Soleil, I think, can take the 3:30 race there for Gavin Cromwell. The penultimate race on the card is a handicap chase over 2.5 miles. And the likes of Benefit Run here, he's just in a wonderful run of form. Really nice winner last time out. Has the 8-pound penalty for that 6-length win at Sligo. The yard couldn't be in much better form. Ross O'Sullivan's had 3 winners in the last week alone. So after a quick reappearance, I think Benefit Run probably ranks as one of the better bets of the day on the card. That's in the 4:05 under the penalty. And we close it out with a bumper. And I wouldn't be surprised to see Noel Mead's runner do well here. He's a hardy bloke. 50 grand he cost at the Tats Cheltenham sale was a pretty decent purchase as well at the Land Rover sale. Won a point to point. The second has since gone on to win as well. Disappointing when last seen back in March, but Noel Mead's won this race 3 times since 2007, and he can do it again with He's a Hardy Bloke. So looking forward to the return of the jumps at Navan, and probably the best bet of the afternoon on Saturday is Benefit Run.